Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. For this next mission, I have decided I am going to take on the Rachni mission to help the Krogan team and whatever the hell's going on out there. It's called Attican Traverse the Rachni. A Krogan scouting team has gone missing while investigating rumors of activity at the Rachni Relay. Investigate the missing team and find out what happened. Okie dokie. We could scan here. Well, we won't get anything, right? I'm not sure if I scanned in here. Because I think when we entered this system, we just automatically went right to the Citadel. Been a while since I looked around systems. Okay. Is it not mapped? Serpent Nebula. Apian Crest, Minos, Wasteland, Ismar Frontier, Crescent Nebula, Shrike Abyssal, Sigurd's Cradle, Ninmah Cluster. Missing Scouts. Wait, where is it? It's Attican Traverse, it said. Scan for Dr. Garneau. Sorry, guys. I am looking for this. Exodus Cluster. Well, I'm pretty sure I've looked at everything. Attican Traverse. It's a cluster, correct? Not what I want. I've actually never gone to the map from the menu, actually. This, we know, is the main plot. Apian Crest, for some reason, I think we've been there. Apian Crest, we've been to. We've been to a few of these. Anospace, and we've been to Exodus Cluster, Petra Nebula, Kite's Nest, Hades Gamma, Gemini Sigma, Ninmah Cluster, Calliston Rift, Sigurd's Cradle, the Shrike Abyssal, Crescent Nebula, Ismar Frontier, Minos Wasteland, and do not understand. Of course you guys are going to be writing comments about where it is, and I'm not going to read them until after I've, you know, found out where the hell to go. Could it be this? Investigate missing scouts? Let's go here. I mean, if that's not it, we'll help other scouts. I don't know. We'll just be helping other people. Maxim Xul. Or Maskim Xul. Fuel depot. I don't know if that's the same scouts that we're talking about. I know it's a team of Krogan. What is this? Listening post. Let's check that out first. I mean, last. Let's look at these planets. Suen. Suen, the Rachni homeworld. Okay, I think we're here. I guess Attican Traverse possibly is not a cluster, but an area of clusters? Like, more like a... I don't know. I'm not going to say geographical because it's in space. A region of space, I guess. I don't know. Suen, the Rachni homeworld, is tidally locked to the system's red dwarf, with one side constantly bombarded by the sun, and the other completely frozen. Life evolves in the Terminator, the perpetual twilight zone between Suen's two extremes. The Rachni mainly foraged underground. Suen's abundant subterranean rivers presented them with a place to thrive. Wrestling with the engineering problems of Suen's extreme surface environment may have given the Rachni their first insights on how to build interstellar spacecraft. Suen was the site of the last battle in the Rachni Wars. When Krogan forces bombarded the planet, the Rachni abandoned their surface buildings for the security of their tunnels. The Krogan, resistant to Suen's toxic atmosphere, carried weapons of mass destruction into the secret chambers of the Rachni Queens and detonated explosions so powerful the sinkholes are still visible today. And this stuff. And we have... ooh. Kashaptu. Kashaptu is the first terrestrial planet the Rachni visited after achieving spaceflight. Makes sense. It's the closest planet to them. Although most of Kashaptu is composed of silicate minerals, the Rachni made an important discovery when they charted the Howling Gulf, an enormous crater near the planet's equator. The depression was caused by the impact of several dozen extrasolar asteroids containing large quantities of element zero. The Rachni took samples of the new element back to Suen for further study. Really interesting. I've actually been trying to picture that lately. Rachni piloting starships. It must be a bizarre thing to see, right? Centuries later, when the Rachni capture the Citadel expedition that opened the relay to their system, their research on Ezo helped them reverse engineer the ship's FTL drives. The Rachni built faster-than-light vessels of their own and rapidly expanded beyond their own stars. Mm-hmm. Third planet? Some kind of gas giant? Damkiana. Damkiana, as the main source of helium-3 in the Maskim-Zul system, is orbited by abandoned recovery stations that the Rachni built during their days of conquest. Because the Rachni trusted in their high tolerance for radiation, the stations were poorly shielded against cosmic rays and have deteriorated over time. The Citadel species built their own stations during the Rachni War, several of which have been maintained to this day. Now we have this belt, which I'm just going to fly around just in case there's anything in there. I've seen that happen at least once. Oh, I missed a planet? Oh. No, I've been there, right? That's the Kashaptu. Never mind. Didn't miss one. Yeah, check out that listening post. Okay. Listening post X-19. Listening post X-19 was built shortly after the Rachni Wars, just in case any Rachni survived the annihilation of Suen. The post orbits the mass relay and is still manned and maintained, although today it largely exists as a customs checkpoint for researchers studying the Rachni homeworld. Among members of the Council militaries, being assigned to the station is seen as a form of punishment or exile, considering there have been no signs of sapient life on Suen for over 1,000 years. The length of the station is 332 meters, the mass is 106,000 metric tons, and has a population of 340. Cool. We don't need stuff. If I scan. Oh, they are aware. That's different than before. In all the other ones I've been into so far, the initial system with the mass relay, the Reapers don't become aware of some, for whatever reason that happened. Now, if I leave the system and come back, they'll still be there. They should be, right? I think you have to complete a quest in order to... Yep. You have to complete a quest. And it'll be this quest, actually, that we do, so when we come back... Yeah, let's just go in. I scan near the gas giant. Let's scan over here. Getting the hell out of here, man. So scary to me for some reason. Utukka for the missing scouts. Okay, let's check out these other planets first. Maldor. This is in Mulla Xul system. The Krogan surveying team that first reported back from Maldor said in characteristic understatement that the planet had a bit of the good stuff if you can get past a little acid. Although Maldor's mineral wealth includes uranium, iridium, and other heavy metals, miners must contend with crushing gravity and atmosphere, boiling temperatures, and clouds of sulfur dioxide. As such, once the planet's most accessible ores were depleted, the mining interest that exploited the planet quickly departed. Alright, let's look at this gas giant here. Saturn-type planet. Kef is a hydrogen-helium gas giant. Records show that the planet should have a helium-3 mining infrastructure, but scans find nothing of the sort. There are neither abnormal heat sources nor space junk from destroyed refineries. If the infrastructure was removed, it was removed entirely and within the last few years. Right, let's mess around with this asteroid belt. We found something. Anakos. Anakos is a metallic asteroid. The surface was once rated for its abundant olivine, which is used for carbon sequestration on heavily populated worlds. More than half the mass of the asteroid has now been depleted, exposing its relatively pure iron-nickel core. It's freaking cold on this asteroid? Yeah. Should I scan near it? Let's scan near it. Do one, at least one little scan. No Reaper activity, huh? Maybe it doesn't happen in planets where you have a quest designation. Maybe that's the thing. Yeah, see, we're completely fine here. This also probably means we won't find anything. It actually makes sense that they do that, so they don't lock you out of getting quests. Utukka. Yeah, there's no markers to indicate like what percentage of goodies we found or anything. Guessing that's in the other system, but I don't want to go back in there right now because there's Reapers in there still, I'm sure. Utukku. Although Utukku is a habitable, extreme temperatures and violent weather have discouraged colonization. Because the planet has little liquid water to retain heat, surface temperatures regularly oscillate between 70 Celsius to negative 60 Celsius. Utukku's vegetation is notable for having evolved flexible central stalks to survive high-speed winds, as well as leathery leaves to shrug off the planet's frequent sandstorms. Animal life is mostly confined to the planet's small oceans. Utukku has few valuable minerals. Alright, let's land. That's right, I forgot we only have this amount of members. It doesn't look like we could fit much more people, does it? Not like the squad selection in Mass Effect 2 where you saw all the little... You know, there was a whole crowd of these people. I have only 4. I've seen her other appearance. Huh? Oh, he's got 3 different... Oh, how many different ones does he have? He looks insane there, like some kind of evil, like, supervillain or something. I got that, and that. I kind of like the spectacle. I'm not choosing him this time, though. I am going to take Liara and Garrus this time. If I had a Krogan, I'd bring one with me. But I don't at the moment. Yeah, I wonder if we got Eve as a squad member at some point. Maybe when the warden's done analyzing her. As well as Morden. It'd be great to have Morden come along. I'm just gonna keep what they have. As far as powers, wow. Concussive shot, I do like, and overload. Increase force and damage to frozen targets. But they have to be frozen. I'm going to increase the recharge speed then. Power concussive shot with the properties of the active ammo power, enabling it to burn, freeze, disrupt, warp, or pierce armor, or increase damage to organics by 100% over 10 seconds, increase force by 50%. This is, unfortunately, organics only. He has armor piercing ammo. That's something different, though. See, he doesn't... Armor... Whoa! Oh, crap! I'm gonna have to go back in the squad. Shepherd. I hit the wrong button.
Our backup's waiting for us at the drop point. Arlak Company. Krogan Commandos.
That's correct, Shepard. They are an accomplished unit. Their decisive action in liberating a colony from Batarian pirates made them famous.
Good to hear. Other than that, there's been no word from a team of Krogan scouts since they went through the Rachni relay.
I don't like the sound of this. The Krogan would have come prepared to fight.
We don't know much, but no Rachni activity has been reported.
Yeah. It doesn't make sense. We let that last Rachni queen live on the condition she disappear forever.
True.
She wouldn't risk everything to start a war.
Just be ready for anything.
There's something we're missing, then.
Yeah, shuttle just arrived. You better get moving, Team 2. See anything, let me know.
Grunt?
Grunt?
Shepard?
I'm like, Shepard. What?
What are you doing here?
He's very happy to
I
see us.
I ask you the same question. Didn't those idiots lock you up?
They did. Put me in lockdown to keep the Batarians off me. Didn't want problems with the Council while they prepared for war. But the situation changed.
Yeah, they got bigger problems, all right. That's why I'm out here running Arlak Company. They're tough, think they're invincible. Reckless, but effective.
Mm-hmm. What happened to you?
Sounds familiar, Grunt. How'd you go from being new and unproven to your own command?
Wasn't easy. When Rex put Arlak Company together, he needed a leader who represented the future of our species. Thanks to you, I completed my rite of passage on Tachanka and became part of Clan Erdnot. I was an equal. And being
awesome.
The strongest, I was chosen to lead this honored company.
Congratulations.
I bet some didn't like a tank-bred Krogan being in charge.
I collected a few scars earning my place here. These Krogan respect me.
It's great to have you here.
You were a pain in the ass, Grunt. But if you're Krogan or half the soldier you are, we might make it out of here.
Hey, glad you're here to crack some heads, Shepard. Hard to believe this might be Rachni. Seems crazy.
Yeah, I'm just not gonna headbutt you.
Rachni. Chance to face the old enemy? Impossible to resist.
We don't know if the Rachni had anything to do with this. We're here to find the scouts. I didn't see any signs of activity during our approach.
Agreed. But this place smells wrong. Like a bad wound. Our scans show the tunnels down there lead to a large central point. If we're lucky, it's a nest.
Sounds like fun. Just like old times, Grunt.
Yay.
Our luck, company!
That
Move
laugh.
Out. Grab what you need, Shepard. Meet me at the scout camp ahead.
Sounds good.
Really glad I brought...
Move out.
Really glad I brought, Garrus for that line. That was awesome. Now... Okay, so he has piercing armor. Armor piercing amp. Right, okay, that's what I was wondering. And then I hit confirm instead of back to this. So I'm going to take this so that we're not limited to organics with that, you know, boost. Overload, I also like. Incapacitate weaker organic enemies for a short duration. Or increase recharge speed. It's not increased by that much. I think we'll take Neural Shock then. Chain Overload is good. Now, I'm going to either upgrade Armor Piercing Ammo or Proximity Mine. Increase health and armor damage by 6%. It's not a lot. Squad mates gain your ammo power at 50% effectiveness. I'll take that. Alright, done. And Liara, yay. Stasis, I don't really use. Warp ammo. Warp. Or pure biotic. Weapon damage by 20%. Power force and duration by 30. Or warp. damage by 40%, duration by 60. We'll increase weapon damage taken to it by a target 15%. Power damage 15%. Let's take this. Let's take a look at Singularity. Expand the Singularity field by 35% for 10 seconds, or detonate Singularity when the field dies to inflict 420 damage across 5 meters. Both seem really good. That's assuming whatever is in the Singularity has not already died. Right? And something has to be 5 meters or less away to get this damage. Guys are going to run around. They're not necessarily going to stay near it. Let's take Expand. Just trying to be as practical as possible with all this. We got 9 points. I could also max out Warp, and I believe I'm going to do that. Increase damage to barriers and armor by 50%. Weaken armored targets by an additional 25%. Barriers and armor. Armored. Okay, Warp. Oh, no doubt. Going to take this Pierce. So this is... So Warp, we'll have to remember, against armored targets if we can. Can I do a warp ammo? Nope. Needs 4. I'm going to save the other points. I'm going to ignore stasis at least for now and save the points for warp ammo and or pure biotic. She has no points and he's done. Okay. Alright. Save my progress. Look around for any goodies. Doubt there'll be anything around here, but... It's supposed to go that way. Oh, what's in here? Spare parts. 1625 credits. Pistol high caliber barrel. Number 2. M382. Okay. M300 Claymore. Ooh. Let's check it out with the loadout. It's new. It's... Oh. It's a shotgun. I'm not gonna use it, guys. I'm just gonna look at it. There's always this flavor text and stuff. Stats. Wow, this thing is heavy as crap. But all the other shotguns are pretty freaking heavy. Well, not all of them. Okay. And I can only imagine with this freaking thing. Capacity, fire rate, suck. Accuracy sucks, but great damage. Yeah, I wouldn't even really use this thing. I mean, great damage, but I'd need to have rounds in the thing, and I'd need to actually hit something, which would be... It looks difficult. The Claymore used to be a hard-hitting but poor-selling shotgun. Due to kickback problems, snapping the arms of anyone but Krogan firing the weapon. After a rehaul of its kinetic dampening system, the Claymore is being rolled out again. As a way to lure back customers, the gun's manufacturer has lowered the shotgun's selling price without skimping on its stopping power. You forget. I think the Claymore shotgun was something that, what's his name? Grunt could use. Alright, so I'm gonna... unequip that. Done.
Not surprised Grunt found his way into the action. Little guy's all grown up. Glad he's here.
Me too. He was very happy to see us. All that laughing was awesome. Check out in here. Oh, they got a weapon bench. Okay. I don't need to use that right now. So machine gun, high caliber barrel. I don't know. Do I want to check out these high caliber barrels? For the pistol? I'm using ultralight and heavy barrel 4. High caliber barrel. Increases damage by 17.5%. Allows wider projectiles, causing more trauma on impact. Basically optimized to maintain penetrative power. Heavy barrel. Oh, increases damage even more, but also increases the rate. That's okay. 35%. Versus 17.5%. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it like it is. And there's one for the submachine gun, assault rifles. Magazine upgrade and ultralight materials. I'm gonna keep it like it is until we get better percentage. Until then, I'll keep a... What did I have? Magazine upgrade, I think? Guess I have more rounds with the thing. Okay.
A long way down.
I was about to say that. She reads my mind. Our resident commercial telepath.
Ready, Shepard. We're right behind you.
What's up? Got some spare parts, though. 875 credits.
You ready to go?
What have you been up to, Rex?
What did you do after Grunt? The collectors were defeated?
Sorry. Don't hit me.
I spent most of my time back on T'Chanka learning what it was to be Krogan. In the lab where I was created, the lessons were like fighting with practice weapons. They had no bite, no impact. I needed the blood and pain. I made mistakes, but I learned.
You really think the Rachni are here?
Did Warlord Okir imprint anything on you about the Rachni during your creation?
Well, what do you know about
them? Okir ensured I knew of the Rachni. They are respected as an enemy. Everyone thought they were dead, defeated by the Krogan. You proved that wrong. If they're here, my blood demands they die.
Feel pretty strongly about this, don't you? And you're leading Arlak Company.
Tell me more about this company.
Arlak means Eye of Wrath. We are named after the fierce T'Chanka son. Rex handpicked us from different clans to show a united Krogan. We were sent because we're the strongest.
And what do you think happened to these scouts?
What happened to the scouting party?
Looks like something dropped half their camp down a hole. Their shuttle must have been lost as well. They weren't going anywhere. Doesn't matter. We're here to find the Rachni and burn them out.
All right, let's get going.
Okay.
Finally. Right behind you, Shepard.
Finally. Well, I'm going in here first. Hope you don't mind. Oh! My god!